Today I would like to show you how to use Vivaldi in a car, specifically the Polestar 2 this time. There's a lot of stuff to unpack here, so let's get started. The first thing we want to do is go into the Play Store. And once you get in here, you just want to search for Vivaldi. Click on Vivaldi and hit install. When you finish the downloading process, you can start up the browser for the first time. First, we want to make sure that the browser is set as standard by selecting it. Here, you'll get a few different options. You could either choose to go the expressway or you can customize the browser immediately. While you're parked or charging your car, one thing you can do is open up a streaming service. So here we have HBO. We're just watching something while we're waiting for the car to get charged up. Another thing you can do with the Vivaldi browser is connect a game controller to your Polestar 2. With USB Type-C, you can just open up a game, plug in your controller, and play whatever you want. In this Polestar 2, you can connect the keyboard with USB Type-C. This way, you can continue working on a document while you're charging your car or you're parked somewhere. Alternatively, you could always make a call within the browser itself because there is a microphone available. Vivaldi has a selection of features available. At the top left of the browser, you can find the side panel. Here you'll find your bookmarks and your speed dial bookmarks. You find your browsing history, your notes, and the translate tool. If you would like to have all your browsing data available here in the car, you can always go down here to the settings, log into your Vivaldi account to start syncing data across devices. So if you have Vivaldi on your phone or your computer, it's easy here to just log in and get started. If you don't have that already, you can choose to do that either in the car, creating an account, or you can do it on your phone or your desktop. So all you gotta do is just log in and synchronize. Vivaldi Sync uses end-to-end encryption to keep your data protected. All right, guys, so that was just a few tips on how to use Vivaldi in your Polestar 2. Stay tuned for more videos like this where we go through the different cars, infotainment systems, and specifically Vivaldi in these cars.